paratha, we have a chapati flour, wheat flour, whole wheat flour, oil, salt to taste, and water to knead the dough. For stuffing, we have mashed potato, matar paneer, green peas frozen, tomato paste, ginger, garlic, green chili paste, fresh cilantro, garam masala, Punjabi garam masala, turmeric powder, salt according to taste, roasted fennel seeds, fennel and sesame seeds, red onion finely chopped. Hello everyone, welcome to superveggiedelight.com and I'm Bhavna. Today I'm going to show you how you can make the Aaloo Matar Paneer stuffed paratha. So to make the Aaloo Matar Paneer stuffed paratha, we have first of all we're going to knead the dough. And I have this about 1.5 cups of chapati flour, the wheat flour, and the whole wheat flour, just 4 to 5 tablespoons only. And into this I am going to add a little bit of salt. You can add the salt according to your taste. And now oil. I would say about 6 to 7 tablespoons of oil that you will need. I'm just going to eyeball it. You need to feel the moistureness into the flour, that much oil that you need. So this is how it looks like. See, when you do like this, it makes a little bit kind of that. That's much you need the oil. And now I'm going to knead the dough with the water. And this is warm water. And keep adding the water slowly. Do not add water at just one time, so that you know that how much water you need. And you need the dough a little bit harder than the chapati flour. A little bit more water and so the dough is ready. And I'm going to smooth out the dough with the oil. You can use the ghee, the clarified butter, if you want to use that. So just a little bit of oil. So this will make the dough smooth. Okay, so we are done with the dough. We're going to cover the dough. Meanwhile, we're going to prepare the stuffing. So I'm going to cover it and keep it on side. So now we're going to work on our stuffing. And for the stuffing, I have the mashed potato. I boiled into the microwave and mashed it about 7 to 8 minutes into the microwave. With this I'm going to add the crumbled paneer. I crumbled the paneer into the food processor. You can use whatever you have. I'm going to add that much. So I had almost 1.5 cup of mashed potato. So this was about 3/4 cup of paneer, the crumbled paneer. Into this I'm going to add the peas, green peas. This is frozen, thawed, and I just cooked about a minute or so into the microwave and then did into the food processor, because you don't want to mash it totally. You need to see the chunks of it. and the red onion. Now this already smells very nice. I am going to add also a little bit sugar, but it's optional. If you don't like the sweetness into the Aaloo Matar Paneer Paratha, then you can skip it. So there, our stuffing is also ready. Now it's time to make the paratha, and I'm going to take a small bowl. Like this. Dust a little bit into the flour. And now I'm going to stuff with the stuffing. Make sure that your stuffing has not too much big chunks in it, otherwise you won't be able to roll over the paratha. And then wrap it. And little more, again dust into the flour a little bit. And roll over nicely and slowly. And roll as much as you can, like as much thin as you can. And I have the tawa already ready, hot. And I'm going to put that into the tawa. One side is already done, so we're going to turn it over. Be careful when you turn it over. See how it's getting puffy? We're going to check on the other side. Almost about to get done. Now I'm going to spread over the oil. And we will turn it over. Again on the other side, we'll spread a little bit of oil. See how nice it looks. Careful when you turn it over, because now it's with the oil, so you oil may splash onto you. So when you use the oil to bake them, it will get nice color, the brown color. Cook both sides till get golden brown. So our Aloo Matar Paneer stuffed paratha is ready. And I'm going to make rest of the paratha now. And I have the serving plate. This Aloo Matar Paneer paratha you can serve with the raita or pickle. That tastes very nice. Or itself, that tastes very nice. Spread just a little bit of butter on it and then serve hot. And it's a wonderful way when you eat hot. We'll be right back.